Good morning, hot dogs. I'm Ms. Scanlon, your College Connection coach. You can find me Monday and Fridays at the green table outside the cafeteria. Today, we're going to continue to build our foundation of knowledge by talking about the different types of colleges. So there are four types of colleges. You've got public universities, private universities, community college, and the for-profit technical schools. Now, the first type is public universities. These were schools that were founded by the state of Indiana, normally back in the 1800s, some in the early 1900s. Now, as Hoosiers, you get a huge discount to go to these schools because your parents' taxes help keep them running. Now, an easy way to tell if it's a public school is, does it have Indiana in the name, and does it have more than 10,000 students? Because public universities tend to be large, both in the number of students and the number of classes that they offer. So that is one good thing about it. It has pretty much every major you could want. Now, some of the popular ones in this area are Purdue University, Indiana University, IUPUI, we even have IU Kokomo, which is called a site school. So Bloomington's considered the main campus, but you can still go to Kokomo and get that Indiana University degree. Then you have private colleges. So these are ones that cost a little bit more because you aren't getting that Indiana discount. But because of that, they also offer really good financial aid. So don't let that sticker price scare you. Just because a lot of them are more $20,000 to $30,000 a year, it doesn't mean you're going to pay anywhere near that number. In fact, some of them might end up being cheaper than the public school $10,000 a year. It just depends on that financial aid, which we'll talk about more in the future. Some examples of private colleges are DePauw University, Earlham, Wabash, Notre Dame. Now, if you like the size of Frankfurt High School, you might consider a private school. These tend to be about 1,000 to 8,000 students. They're a lot smaller. You're more likely to get that one-on-one connection with your professor and know everyone in your class. But they might not have the major you're looking for, so make sure you keep that in mind. Plus, some of these private colleges have more of a Christian affiliation and require chapel so many times a week. So if that's something that's good for you, definitely check those out. If it's something that might be an issue for you, I'd recommend steering away. Then you have community colleges. Indiana's only community college is Ivy Tech. Now, this is going to be your cheapest option without any financial aid, about $4,000 a year. Again, financial aid makes all the difference in how much you're actually paying. Don't let that sticker price stop you from applying. Now, the reason why Ivy Tech is so cheap is because it only offers up to two-year degrees. You can get your certifications or you can get an associate's degree. Now, something else really great about Indiana, our group of legislators came together and they decided it needs to be easy to transfer from one college to another. So they took your general studies, your English, your math, your science, your foreign language, and they said those classes have to transfer from any public university to any other in Indiana. Legally, it has to. So that means if you want to stay close to home, save some money, you can start at Ivy Tech and get all those general studies out of the way. They're going to be required for pretty much any major you want to do. And then any of Indiana's public colleges have to take those majors exactly as they came. Now, a lot of private universities are going to honor that as well. It just might, you might want to check before you start Ivy Tech if that's what you're considering. And even out of state, a lot of colleges will take it. It's just hard to know if it's going to be the same exact class for them or not. Then you have the for-profit schools and the technical schools. Now, for-profit means that whenever the college makes a profit off of tuition, off of grants what the government gives them, it goes into paying the board that came together to create the college. Whereas public, private, community colleges, all that money goes back into the college and helping it grow and get better. Now, these colleges are nice because they really don't care so much about what you did in high school, and they're a lot more focused towards meeting the needs of the community, of what jobs people really need in that area. So in that way, it's nice. Plus, it's really flexible around your schedule if you're working a lot. However, there have been issues with these kind of colleges closing down with not meeting accreditation. So if you are considering one of these schools, Harrison College, the International Business College, just make sure you really do your research first. Okay, well, hopefully that gives you an idea of what it means when someone says it's a public university versus a private and how tuition works. But if you have any questions on what the differences are between different schools, come and see me. I'm happy to talk about it.